Welcome everybody to today's session. Today's session is going to be on the Serenity Prayer. Most of you have probably heard of it, maybe even memorized it. It's been around for a long time and been a part of a lot of self-help or recovery experiences. What is the Serenity Prayer? It states, God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference. Now, you don't have to be religious or believe in God to have the philosophy of this prayer impact your life. And that's what I teach a lot of people in therapy. And we go over this quite a bit in a lot of different life challenges, whether it's addiction, whether it's stress or anxiety, or any unhealthy emotion. So let's look at it piece by piece. The first sentence says, God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change. What is serenity? Serenity is a state of being that is calm and peaceful. Don't we all want more calm and peace in our life? We live in a hectic world that is stressful, that has a lot of challenges. So having calm and peace is really important to each one of us and our personal happiness and well-being. So how does the Serenity Prayer help us be calm and peaceful? Well, this first part, again, we're trying to accept the things we cannot change. And it is my experience that a lot of people come into therapy with stress and anxiety, and they're stressing about and having anxiety over things that are completely out of their control. And you probably experienced this in your life too. Just think about the things that, again, cause you stress and anxiety and ask yourself, do I have control over this right now in my life? Usually the answer is no. And we have to learn to be able to accept the things that we can't change and be able to let them go. If you're religious, you may use the phrase also, let go and let God, or having faith and trust that these things will all work out. If you're not religious, you can just have the attitude of, this too will pass, or I can't do anything about it, so again, I'm going to let it go and not spend the effort and the energy in worrying about something that I cannot change. It just doesn't do well for our emotional well-being, our mental well-being, our physical well-being, or our spiritual well-being. It really can affect us in all areas if we spend a lot of effort and energy worrying and stressing about things that are out of our control. So that's the first part, is learning to accept those things. And when we do that, we are going to get serenity. We are going to have more calm and peace in our life, I believe wholeheartedly. The second piece to this prayer is courage to change the things I can. Okay, this is a big piece. Now we can take a look at these things in our life, these circumstances, these situations that may be causing our stress and anxiety, and going, okay, is it something I can change in my life? And if it is, then again, having that courage and that willingness to put forth the effort and the energy in changing it, not just worrying about it, but really doing something about it. So if we look at these two pieces, serenity to accept the things we cannot change, courage to change the things we can, and we really take the time in different circumstances and different situations to really evaluate that and to be aware of which part of this prayer or philosophy we're dealing with, again, I think we're going to be a lot less stressed out. We're going to have that serenity, that calm, and that peace in our life. The final part to the Serenity Prayer is wisdom to know the difference. Now, this may seem simple, but I think it does take wisdom to really know what can I control or change in my life versus what can't I? Because I think we get on autopilot and we automatically assume or think that this is something I can't change or control, when really it is. Or we think we can control it and we think we have some control over a situation when we really don't. So this is a big piece, being able to look in the mirror and be able to admit to ourselves if we can or cannot change or control a situation. Now, control is really an illusion, isn't it? There's not a lot of things we can control in life except for ourselves. So if we think we can control the outcome or the situation that is outside of ourselves, I think we're fooling ourselves. And again, we're going to cause ourselves more stress and anxiety that is really unnecessary. And I think it really also is about honesty. We have to be honest with ourselves. We have to be honest whether we can control the situation, and then we have to be willing to do something about it, and that's where the courage comes in. Or we have to be honest with ourselves and know, I can't change this. This is not something I can control. This is out of my ability to do so. And that can be difficult because a lot of us are in need of control of other people or of things that, again, we really don't or can't have control of. And this really causes a lot of stress and anxiety and discomfort in our lives. So here's my challenge for today. Really take a look at your life and ask yourself, the things that you stress over, are they things that you can change or you can't? Are there things that you can control or you can't? And then really be willing to let go of the things that you have no control over or that you can't change, or take the time to make the change that you need to make to bring that peace and calmness and serenity into your life. I also challenge you to really look at the Serenity Prayer and memorize it. And when you go into stressful situations, review it in your mind and ask yourself these questions that we're talking about, if you can or cannot control it or change it in your life. If this was helpful, please give the video a thumbs up. Please share it with somebody that also may find it helpful in their life. Also, if you haven't already, please subscribe to this channel and you can get each video that comes out when it does. Another thing I would like you to do is, if you have topics of interest that you would like me to make a video on, please put that in the comments section. I really want this channel to be about helping you and helping those that are watching. So again, if you have a topic of interest, please let me know and I would love to share some thoughts on it. Make it a great day and make it a great week.